Hello. Hello everyone. Good afternoon and welcome to summer school in the fourth day. So today's topic will be the management of agribusiness information. And today's lecturer will be Dr. Priyono. He graduated from Universitas Gajah Mada Indonesia and he is the lecturer in Universitas Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta. And today is the fourth day of the summer school, so we hope you still enjoy it and then can get the active discussion after his presentation. Because after his presentation, we will open discussion like the day before yesterday or the day before yesterday. So we will do discussion every day and then after discussion, we will do same as yesterday, which is every participant need to do the assignment. So actually, Dr. Priyono is here with me because we are in the same roof, same office. So I will call Dr. Priyono to start the presentation. Your time around 40 to 50 minutes, Dr. Okay, please.
Hello, thank you, Pak Zaki, for this time. I will discuss about this topic today about management of agribusiness information. First, I will share my slide. Okay, you can see this slide. Hello. Okay, one of the topic about management of agribusiness is about ICT for agribusiness. Or we can say information and communication technology for agribusiness. Okay, we will explain about agribusiness. The agribusiness system consists of some subsystem. The first is input supply subsystem, and second production subsystem, and the third about output marketing subsystem, and the one other about institution and services. Agribusiness consists of from upstream until downstream industry integrated. They are about plantation or fruits production for provide industry, food industry, and second about livestock production for provide about meat, eggs or milk. And other sector about fishery, and the last sector about forestry. It is provide industry or manufacture for maple and the other. Okay, we will can say that agribusiness can see both consumption and production, and between them we can say technology and industry for product transformation, and one can about distribution. About production, actually there are three production main or primary production for crop production and animal production. And processing product by transformation production, and the activity of distribution about packaging, transportation, development, supply chain, and the other. So one of the support in this activity in agriculture, that is about technology input. One of technology input is as information system to connect the information part of the agriculture about connected consumption with production, distribution, and transformation. It is very important, and actually in this time, in this era. So, information can build and develop input for product transformation. Then it is both one of the innovation in the agriculture to develop agribusiness in this in the world. Like some input in agriculture can innovate to transform it, become output that sustain, can efficient, can profitable, and high productivity. We know that in country develop step by step, and we can see some character in states of national or country to growth by stakes, like stake of national competitive development. The first is factor driven, or it is just on natural resources or factor condition. And the second stage is the country can aggressive investment. Beside factor condition, they have demand condition and recovery. And the next step about innovation driven, the country have more creative and have innovation for get more benefit from the development. Besides factor condition, actually natural resources, they have demand condition, reformate, and related that and supporting industry. So it's can more sustainable and country development. This is there are three condition. It's country, the factor driven state, efficiency driven state, and innovation driven state. The country that have a factor driven states is compete based on their factor. And the state of development has primary and well-fulfilled and private institution, while develop infrastructure, stable macroeconomic environment. And second, the country with condition efficiency driven states, and the state the country begin to develop more efficient process and increase product quality. They have higher education and training, efficient, good, and well functioning labor market, and the other. And the country that innovation demonstrates as country move to into the innovation driven, reason by as much that they are able to sustain and innovate associate center of living only in their business compete with new and unique product. So it's more sustainable than the other. How about the information in the agribusiness? We know that we can spread that labor composition in the world, state by state or decade by decade change. Actually, in the farming labor decline since 19th until now. So it's about labor condition in farming, in agriculture. So what happened with it? It's because industry or technology development. Actually, in agriculture and agribusiness, we conduct by information management system, and it can more effective, more efficient. So the labor decline but time until now. So we can know that business application of computer. It is very, very important, and we can say that it's very friendly in this era because most of the activity using by management information system and computerized technology. Actually, in the management or organization, you know that the management system constructs by information, and it can effectively in the all of activity in the world. Okay, we can say that information is one of the important thing in the era. We can collect the data, so the data collection can construct to be information. So the information is one of most important thing to construct the knowledge, and the knowledge we can construct to be intelligent, and they can develop again. Until now, we can say that
It is developed about artificial intelligence in this era. The important value for data source in agribusiness. So to develop agribusiness, to develop agriculture for in the world. We have to develop by information system. We need support by information system. Let's know every activity effectively. We can conduct our activity by using information. So information is very important to create and to construct in the system and management. It is about data and information. We can see in the agriculture there are temperature data and humidity data, and all of them we can give about information that is about information about weather and other data we can collect and we can construct to be an information in the our activity actually in agribusiness or agriculture. Maybe in the other case, data about salinity, data about humidity in soil, we can say we can get information about soil fertility or soil condition and other information about activity or about case in agriculture. So it is very important to construct, to collect, to get information and to be manager can make decision for their activity. How the manager can make decision. It is about information process. For input is data, database, or raw data, and the collecting data we can process by analysis and other process. And it can give output about information and important information for decision the manager, for decision the farmer, and other activity in agriculture. So it is a system, information system process in agriculture or farmer or as a make decision. In the Chile, we can see that data analysis process, like in this figure, you can see that data processing technique and data analysis in technique by data verification and data analysis like statistics and other analysis, and the output can give information to make the decision for the manager or for the farmer. So the process, processing data, processing information can give a function to the some stakeholder, or maybe some stakeholder that the interruption in their business. Like maybe interaction between supplier that provide a raw material or input for agriculture, and interact with the producer or farmer, and interact with a customer that need about raw material or the services for their needs, and other stakeholder like government as a regulatory agencies or other companies. So they interact and interacting in turn. It is needs important information. For important information, they need data source. So quality of information, they need information system, and management information system is will be need for their activity in the world. And then to support this activity, to support this data source, to support the information, and to manage their information and their activity, it is can support by hardware and software of technology for manage the information. It is hardware and software by computer and information and communication technology for processing data, for disseminating information, and it is for important to make decision and this activity in agribusiness. You know that the activity actually in agribusiness, they want to get good performance in this in their business. And it is need supporting for their business. They have to conduct their management well and conduct their business process well. And it is need support information system. So for get a good performance in their agribusiness, like from profitable and for strategic position, they have to do business process and management activities like supply chain management, enterprise, customer management, and knowledge management, it is a business process that they have to manage. They have to create and innovate by technology and information technology. And the other activity for activities in management or organization, they have to well manage by planning, coordinating, controlling, and decision making. We have need support about information and information quality, information defined by information system that they build in their business, like how to collect data, how to processing data, and how to disseminate their data for their business, for their organization, and it is important for their performance business. So, the business, actually in the agribusiness, we can see that their business, how to construct, how to arrange comprehensively and collaborate the harmony about organization and management by using technology, actually in information and communication technology. we can see about perspective of information system. There are two perspective. One is information system literacy, and the second is computer literacy. Information system literacy explain about the software in information technology. It is about understanding of information system that include behavior knowledge about organization and individual using information system and technical knowledge about computer. And the computer literacy knowledge about information technology, focusing understand how computer-based technology work, how to operate it, and etc. So, we can do activity in business. Actually, we can see about major business function. There are sales and marketing, and manufacturing, finance, accounting, and human resources. They can manage, they can conduct well by using information system or by using information that's managed well and connected one and to the other. So by managed comprehensively, the manager can do better decision making and give perform their agribusiness. So to good organization, to build organization better, we have to know about key element in the organization. The first, people. People as a manager, as a knowledge worker, as a data worker, production or service worker. it's an important element because it's a conductor in their activity in and their business. And the second key element is structure. How to connect one group to other group. How to collaborate, how to operate about our structure as organization and this organization and one group and the other group in their cooperation. And the third about operating procedure, it is about guidance and rule for action for the activity in this in the agribusiness. And the four about politics, it is a power to proceed or getting this activity of this thing done in the agribusiness. And the last about culture, value, social value, by custom of behavior and the norm of in the community, it is important in the organization. The other side, we have to know about management. That management consists by some level. Level of the management, at least three. The first is senior manager. The senior manager make long range strategy. Long for long time activity like vision in the their company or their business. The decision is very important to long strategic develop the product and services. And second, the middle manager. This the middle manager as a create all the arrange program for strategic planning and they arrange activity for the business of the firm. And the last about operational manager is just do activity daily for short time, short term about activity. Just operate the activity in the firm. And we can say, okay, we can approach the information system by two approach. One is technical approach. The technical approach consists about management science, computer science, and operation research. They more about they explain or they do more in technical. And one approach, the other approach is about behavior approach. They learn about psychology, economic and sociology. It's more explain about human condition and human resources development. It is one of combine about socio and technical system approach. We can say the choose alternative from alternative and combine the design of socio and design of technical until get the comprehensive final design and get the business purpose. So we can say see about interdependence about business and information system. We know what business is organization to get provide by strategy, by guidance or by procedure, and to conduct the business. It needs information system that consists by software, by hardware, and input database, and to get information, to get input, we need communication or to share the information. It is need information on communication technology. So it is for develop the business is it is important to develop information system in the firm or in the their business. It is a develop information or managerial from era to era until now, and we know that this era is digital era. Today, digital information web extending beyond in the enterprise. Most of the activity, most of the business based on digital, based on the web, and based on the information and communication technology. So we can see that in this area is information system is more important to develop the customer beyond in the enterprise. So by digital, by information system, and the manager or the businessman can get more simple in their activity, in their organize, in their organization, or the manager, or their management, because by support of information system, the management can effectively and more efficient and more profitable. Like in this figure, on this picture, we can see that the traditional is not effective, not efficient, but in the modern organization, like in the below, we can see it's more simple than the above. Or we can see this picture. By traditional activity or management, less support information system, it needs a more long time. But above side, we can see that by support information system well, it is more just 5 days for finishing their activity of their business. In the other hand, we can see too, by information and technology communication technology, the business can connect it. For example, factory can connect it by customer, or maybe connected by supplier and other stakeholder, and they can change their information to collaborate their activity of their business. Okay, we can see information architecture and information technology infrastructure. Particularly a process about coordination, and horizontally we can see activity from about business. For example, in agribusiness, it is supply chain management in food, maybe, or supply chain on raw material for industry. And the other hand, about customer relationship management system, its system both supply chain, customer relation management, they have information system. They have to develop well by information system. And they can connect that information for supply chain to customer. And it is a comprehensive business by technology infrastructure, actually in information. That is they support by IT infrastructure to provide hardware, software, data storage, and network in their activity and their business. It is a sample about the business or agribusiness system in about mushroom agribusiness. They have collaboration in agribusiness mushroom agribusiness. Its stakeholder have activity like maybe this about this site about production supplier. Sawmill business, rice mill business, and farm shop. You know, sawmill business, it is provide sawdust. Maybe about wood waste. And rice mill business, it provide rice waste for planting media mushroom. So production supplier is provide the raw material for mushroom production. Instead of mushroom production, there is mushroom seed, mushroom breed, and mushroom production or mushroom cultivation for product the mushroom. And mushroom seed, they need seed marketing to get seed for mushroom seed. Mushroom production need feedlot marketing, need planting media for cultivation, for the cultivating the mushroom. Or mushroom production, fresh product marketing, need fresh product marketing for sell the product. Or direct to agro industry like culinary or pharmaceutical. It is about post harvesting or post product. And under support institution like agriculture agency, board of meteorology and climatology geophysics, and other association for develop their business. It is collaboration and information sharing inter-stakeholder in the mushroom agribusiness. We can see one by one. The first agribusiness input system. There are three stakeholder. The first sawmill business unit that provide waste wood from raw material, planting media, and rice mill business unit. It provide the raw material for planting media too, and farm shop to cultivate the mushroom. In the sawmill business, data input the system about profile, production capacity, and price, and information about quantity of raw material for planting media, and data input about rice mill profile, product, same capacity, and price. And farm shop about product profile, price, stock status, ready or not, or order status, credit or opportunity. And the second system about production system in agribusiness. There are seeding business unit, provide the seed, and breeding provide backlog. Backlog mean media planting for cultivate the mushroom, and third about mushroom production main business unit in mushroom, and it's provide input data about profile, production capacity, price, stock position, and etc. So it's have information about its business, information about seed, of information about big crop or planting media, and information about production capacity. And the thought about post harvesting system. That there are two, like culinary agro industry for processing, and or pharmacy industry. And it is an important system that in agribusiness, actually in mushroom agribusiness, marketing system. Marketing system for seed, backlog or planting planting media, fresh product marketing and process product marketing. And the support and the system is support system. Both of meteorology, climatology, and geophysics provide weather information, agricultural agency, association or corporation, and industry trade agency. They can support the mushroom business. It is interrelation in the mushroom agribusiness from each stakeholder in agribusiness mushroom. So they are the case in agribusiness information. It can collect the farmer production to retail and supply to customer. All activity supply chain for agribusiness production like transportation, processing, food transformation, and distribution. develop information system in agriculture is IoT or Internet of Thing in Agriculture. It is connected the activity in agriculture from upstream to downstream and all just in production system. Like this picture, there are many data in production system and collect and collaborate to get information and turned up well to manage their production system in on farm. They can manage their information in each activity in agribusiness interfaced on the camp, on the office, so we can more effective and efficient in this business. It is information about activity in agriculture for input for activity farmer, support by laboratory or research and development, and it is can collaborate to develop their activity business in agriculture. By manage the information in all of the activity in agriculture, the manager can conduct all of the activity both of in field production, port harvesting, and marketing. Centered by the manager. So by using the information system, information and communication technology used in agriculture to develop their activity and their business more effective, more profitable, and more efficient. It is just some sample in activity in agriculture by using IoT or information technology. Okay, it's just some maybe we can see about what's about some video to get described about activity in agriculture by using the Internet of Things or information and communication technology. Yeah. Production system by using information technology for water irrigation, for pesticides and disease management. Climate control or climate monitoring. Collecting data and analyzing for good decision making. One more, okay? Yeah, it is about mini greenhouse that conduct by information system and management. The condition more control by automatically software and hardware. All of the information about plant growth can be controlled and conduct using automatically machine and systematically by using technology information. Control the line. Control the pesticide and disease management. Control the water irrigation by using automatically machine. Data computerized and analyzing by the operator. Okay, I think it's enough. Just little information for switch your mind to get more information, more knowledge, and more knowledge. I think enough, and I give back to
what exactly.
Okay, thank you very much for Dr. Priyono for the presentation. I think today's presentation is quite related to yesterday's presentation, right? Because yesterday Dr. Andri was presenting about the technology, how to make the agriculture, precision agriculture, such as researching about the movement of the leaves, something like that. Actually, that kind of technology is related to each other. So when we are talking about agriculture, it's not about producing food only, but if you talk about the agriculture, we need to talk about like the integrated system, producing food, post-harvesting, technology. After that, we need to talk about the business, something like that. So actually, the summer school topics is have a relation among each topics. So today's topic is about the management of agribusiness information. And then we found it that when we talk about agribusiness is related with the post-harvesting. In the second day, we know that Prof. Yuli Witono explained about the supply chain. And then the third day, Dr. Andri talk about the precision of agriculture, something like that. And then the fourth day, we talk about the information system. So each other, I think, has relation. Okay, next we will enter to the discussion. First question come from from Universitas Muhammadiyah Purwokerto UMP from Miss Meilasari Wijayanti. Please, Miss Meilasari, you can ask.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you for the opportunity. I'm Melasari from UMP, and I have a question for you, Dr. Triyono. Many farmers in Indonesia are traditional farmers and lack knowledge of technology. What is the solution for traditional farmers in information system? Do they only get it from the government through counseling, or what about it, sir? Thank you, sir.
Okay, I think one question, one answer, Doctor. So okay. Please answer the question.
Thank you, Mbak Melia. Mayla, sorry. Yeah. From the question. Yeah, it is a condition in Indonesia, or maybe in developing country. Lack of knowledge, lack of information system. So to develop the agriculture or agribusiness, we have to support the young generation that, or we can say that millennial generation to develop the agriculture by the information and technology development. We cannot hope to the old generation. We have to support the young generation to control the activity in agriculture by technology development in this area. And I think the millennial generation is more convenient or more comfortable with this technology. I think it's more friendly for with technology to support activity in agriculture more actively, more modern, and more developed. I think
it is, you know, I think it's an idea, and it is an I think it is in my opinion.
How about that, Miss Melasari?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay. Next, the question come from Universitas 11 Maret, Mr. Nugroho Hasan. You can ask, Mr.
Okay, thank you, sir, for the opportunity. I want to ask to Mr. One of key management information of agribusiness is politics in the threat that Mr. speak. And this is can be a problem on role of agribusiness, especially in tropical area, because have any potential fruit and vegetable that can planting in tropical area. So many important people can monopoly that and can lose or can risk the farmer. And how solution of that problem? Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Nugroho. Can you?
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Mas Nugroho Hasan from Solo, from UNS. One of the problem in the agribusiness is monopoly. And it can lose farmer. So we can study about supply chain. We can identify the supply chain as fair or not, about the flow of money, flow of information, flow of product. Information is one of the commodity in the information and communication technology. The monopoly have because information flow is not fair. So we have to study the supply chain about the fairly about the information, fairly about to fairly about flow money and flow product. So technology information can get our stakeholder and get information fairly and anticipate the loose farmer, anticipate of monopoly, because in the digital era we can get information directly. Maybe customer can directly get information from the farmer, or the farmer can directly give information this product to the customer or to the market place and the other. So I think by information and communication technology, the farmer can anticipate this condition, and it is needs support by young generation. The millennial generation can help the farmer to sell their product in the market and give price, visible price for their activity, for their business. I think it's clear. or maybe still question?
How about that, Mr. Nugroho?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, next question.
That's enough. Thank you, sir.
Okay, yeah. You're welcome.
Welcome.
Okay, next question is come from Universitas Perjuangan Tasikmalaya, Mr. Dikri, please. Mr. Dikri. Mr. Dikri. Ah, we cannot hear your voice. No voice, sir. No voice. Maybe you can try to unplug the mic and then plug again, plug in again and try. Unfortunately, we still cannot hear your voice. Okay, meanwhile, you fix the problem. Let's ask the other participant. Is there any other participant who want to ask Dr. Triyono? Hello? Is there any other participant who want to ask Dr. Triyono? I think his presentation was excellent regarding how we understand the management of agribusiness information. Okay, next question come from Universitas 11 Maret, Miss Hafni Amalia, please. Miss Hafni Amalia, please.
Okay, thank you, sir, for this opportunity. Let me introduce myself. My name is Hafni from 11 Maret University. I will ask some question about the machine learning from the big data analysis in the integrated agriculture. So my question is, what about the readiness or kesiapan dari human resources and facilities or infrastructure integration of information technologies in agribusiness? Maybe if we look from the Indonesian scale, it's very big, but how about in micro scale, especially in Yogyakarta, because the OMU is from it's located in Yogyakarta. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Please, Dr. Triyono, maybe you can answer.
Thank you for question from
Ms. Hafni.
Ms. Hafni, yeah. Yeah, one of the problem in this activity is infrastructure providing. Actually, for using information and communication technology about providing about internet communication infrastructure, I think it's a problem, especially in East Indonesia, maybe East Indonesia or other island in out of Java. So it is a problem on, and maybe the government has to provide and priority this activity for provide this infrastructure. Because it is a problem to like this like today, the student had problem about internet connection, signal and other like about the communication. So it is a problem, big problem in this, in our country. So maybe we can, yeah, maybe we can collaborate with some of expert on our student. They are the program like maybe electro or IT information technology program. We collaborate to create, to innovate how to solve the problem. It is our challenge to use the information and communication technology for agribusiness development. I think it is not yeah, difficult enough, but we have to face it, and we have to get alternative to get solution this problem. Maybe tomorrow or next time there are some fine technology, new technology for develop the information connection like that, and or maybe just simple technology but can conduct by the community, not only the corporate technology corporation only, but technology, simple technology, yeah, that can community develop like that. Maybe in the next time this kind of solution can find. I think it is my opinion, and yeah, difficult enough to solve, not only depend on the government, but we have we hope government can priority this problem to solve in today and next time, I think.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Triana. Is that enough, Ms. Tafni?
And I give the feedback. And then what about the pilot project? Maybe in Yogyakarta or in the other area, it's like the example of integrated system of agriculture. Maybe I can Google it more in Google like that. Maybe you can give me suggestion. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you for your response, and I think it's good idea to develop and make or build a project about integrated agricultural system in Yogyakarta, especially in Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta. We can collaborate with other university or other community, other stakeholder. We can collaborate with some of Muhammadiyah in Yogyakarta, in other provinces maybe, to arrange this idea. I think it's good idea. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Triano. Let's move to the next participant who want to ask, which is Mr. Muhammad Sufi bin Muhammad come from University Malaysia Terengganu. Please, Mister.
Hello. Thank you for the opportunity to give me a floor to ask the question. For the first question, are the farmer able to apply the agriculture digital in their business due to the complexity? Even the young generation still cannot adapt the digital technology in their business. And I want to know what is your opinion about this, Doctor?
Okay, thank you.
Bagaimana petani bisa mengadaptasi pertanian digital alat terkait dengan kompleksan digital?
Yeah. Okay. Thank you for your question. It is good question, and you know about complexity in agriculture, especially social and economic condition about farmer, especially in the developing countries, it is complex enough about the condition and the problem. So the government rule and the institutional, I think, can take a role to assist for the farmer to adaptation using digital information or using information and technology in communication. Maybe in Indonesia we can support the student from campus to assist the community, to assist them, to mentor the farmer to use the information and technology, and it is education for the farmer. Collaboration in the between campus or research study with the community, with the government to educate the farmer, so step by step they can adopt. They can adaptation for use the digital literacy and digital and technology and information communication. I think it's one of the solution for the problem and complexity problem in the farmer or on the agriculture.
How about the answer, Mr. Suvi? Is that enough?
Yes, I see your point. That's a very good solution. And for the second question, I want to know what is the strategy that might be efficient to deliver all those information to the rural farmer, because they does not have a connection to the other world, like the internet, and how we can deliver all those information to them. What is the most efficient delivery way to deliver to them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I see. I think the government have provide the internet, provide the infrastructure of communication, and maybe collaborate with the communication information or communication corporation to provide the infrastructure of internet, infrastructure of communication. I think can do it. The economy will be more survive. The economy will be developed, and it is more prospective for communication corporation to provide this infrastructure.
Or maybe in Indonesia we have like agricultural extension advisor, so to deliver the policy or regulation from the government or subsidy or other program in Indonesia, we can use that advisor, agricultural extension advisor, that actually this advisor can available in every district of Indonesia. Most of every district in Indonesia has this advisor. Okay, how about that, Mr. Subi?
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, let's move to the next question. The next question comes from Universitas Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta, which is Miss Aisha Rizky Ananda, please.
Assalamualaikum. I'm Aisha Rizky Ananda from Universitas.
Miss Aisha, we cannot hear your voice clearly. Too low.
Very low.
Hello, Miss Aisha.
Assalamualaikum.
Okay,
I'll see
you.
Ah, we cannot hear.
Can you hear me?
We cannot. Yeah. Or you can write your question in the chat. Let's move the. Please write your question in the chat. Okay, let's move to the next question. Come from Universitas Muhammadiyah, Universitas Perjuangan Tasikmalaya. Mr. Dikri, are you still there? Mr. Dikri, we cannot hear your voice. I think you have problem with the device, yeah.
Or maybe write in the chat.
Or maybe you can write your question in the chat. Okay, let me read for the question from Aisha, Universitas Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta. Her question is, Dr. Triyono explained earlier about the technology in agriculture, but technology in land. My question is whether there is an example of agricultural technology in marketing, such as example the delivery of vegetables or fruit, but the system is like an online shop. And the problem is not if the vegetable or fruit will rot or the condition is not good if it's too long on the way. It's something like that. Can you explain the problem?
Okay, thank you for your question. I think it's a interesting question, and it's a problem about agricultural product actually in horticulture product like vegetable and fruit. So the product is a very simple characteristic first to I think it's not for a long time, it's not. So I think by using information, by using information technology, the customer can ask about the product quality, and maybe they can forecast about time to deliver. So it can calculate and it can forecast about the time and the product condition, and so it can conduct how product to deliver, and maybe make handle by technology for storage, support by technology for storage, and technology production and technology harvesting technology. So the product can deliver to the customer suitable with the customer question, like that. I think by information, I think the producer can forecast, can calculate the condition and to handle the product condition and control the product quality, so the customer question can get good services.
Okay, I think that's okay, Miss Aisha. Next, let's move to the last question, Dr. It comes from Mr. Dikli from Universitas Perjuangan Tasikmalaya. His question is, what do you think about the existence of the middleman or broker in the supply chain?
Is
benefit for us or not?
The broker, middleman. It is problem, but I think he is help to the customer and help to the farmer or producer. But the important thing that they have to fairly in the activity. Valid information, and I think by technology, by information, I think it can solve, and the customer and the producer can communicate each other, and I think no information that not open, all of information can open by using information and technology and communication technology. So I think by using information technology to decrease of middleman control, I think it's can use
if for activity in marketing, activity in selling and requesting about agriculture product and input agriculture.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Triyana. Can you give a closing statement?
Yeah, thank you. In this area, in this era, digital technology is very, very important to develop and to support this agriculture to more growth and to help the farmer to get their welfare. I think it's very, very strategic for develop the agriculture, and it can help the farmer to get this, their welfare and more better in their life. I think in the next time, by using information and communication technology in agriculture activity or agribusiness activity will be developed and will be modern, and I think more interesting for the all in the world, I think.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Triyana.
Thank you.
I think what Dr. Triyana presented today is important to understand what agribusiness is, because like I mentioned before, when we talk about agriculture, it's not only producing food, but we need to understand agriculture is a holistic and complex term. So we need to understand the farmer's character, and then the marketing character is, and so on. So today I think it's already finished, and then please don't miss tomorrow, because tomorrow is the last day of the summer school. Tomorrow topic will be marketing on halal product. Why we choose halal product become one of the topic to be learned in the summer school, because Indonesia is majority is Islam, and then in the world Islam religion is a growing religion, and then halal product issue is become attention for many parties, not only in the Islamic religion but also non-Islamic religion. They are talking about the halal product, like in Japan, in China, in Thailand, they are selling halal product, because the tourists that come from the Islamic countries are increasing day by day, so they need to provide halal product. And then the potency to produce halal product and sell halal product is getting bigger. So many parties are focusing how halal product can be sold, how they can develop the halal product. Therefore, tomorrow we will invite Dr. Juwaida from University Putra Malaysia. Her research are focusing on the marketing of halal product. So I think she has excellent ability to present the topic of marketing on halal product. So today I will share the link of the assignment. Please share the link assignment. You can find in the slide of the Zoom, and then also we will share in the WhatsApp group. Please do the assignment before today's midnight. Okay, and then as your information, tomorrow in the end of the summer school, we will announce the best participant, and then we will announce the most active participant, and the most the favorite participant, also other. So we will announce tomorrow that the announcement will be directly led by the head of Department of Agribusiness, Universitas Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta. I think that's all for today. See you tomorrow. Don't miss it. Please be on time and do your assignment. See you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you. Bye.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.